Hi, my fellow English learner. Neuroscience, history, paleontology, and astrophysics. These are four topics of the books I'm going to recommend to you today. If that sounds intimidating, don't worry, I've got you covered. I found five amazing and easy nonfiction books in English that you're capable of reading if you're an intermediate, upper intermediate, or advanced English learner. Bear in mind that popular science books are not as easy to read as, let's say, children's books. You will come across challenging words and concepts. I'm going to include quotes from each book so that you could feel the language a little bit better. Let's dive in. Book number one, Why We Sleep, The New Science of Sleep and Dreams by Matthew Walker. I'm gonna start with the scariest book I've ever read in my entire life. No, seriously. Bad news, guys. According to a ton of research, the consequences of not sleeping well are devastating for our immune systems, our memory, and our learning. The book is written by a neuroscientist, and every statement you read in the book is backed by research and clinical practice. Why We Sleep is a fascinating read, especially if you want to learn more about how our brain works. He also gives some advice on how to sleep better. Here's a quote. If you don't sleep the very first night after learning, you lose the chance to consolidate those memories, even if you get lots of catch-up sleep thereafter. In terms of memory, then, sleep is not like the bank. You cannot accumulate a debt and hope to pay it off at a later point in time. Sleep for memory consolidation is an all-or-nothing event. So, do you want to improve English? Sleep properly. Book number two, Sapiens, A Brief History of Humankind by Yuval Noah Harari. You've probably heard about this book because it's widely popular. Harari is an Israeli historian, professor, and author, and he has a gift for explaining very complex issues in a very accessible way. He talks about early human history, our society, and gives us a glimpse into the possible future. His writing style is very easy to read and pretty enjoyable to read, even though this book is pretty thick. The romantic contrast between modern industry that destroys nature and our ancestors who lived in harmony with nature is groundless. Long before the Industrial Revolution, Homo sapiens held the record among all organisms for driving the most plant and animal species to their extinctions. We have the dubious distinction of being the deadliest species in the annals of life. Book number three, The Rise and Fall of the Dinosaurs, The Untold Story of a Lost World by Steve Brusatte. Did you like learning about dinosaurs when you were a child? I didn't. I didn't care about dinosaurs at all before I picked up this book a few years ago. I do prefer dragons, but dinosaurs are really interesting. The book is written by a young American paleontologist. And the thing I like the most is that he tells the most exciting personal stories about his adventures, as well as the science and history of dinosaurs. It's a fun and easy book to read, and you learn so much cool stuff. Bats look and behave a whole lot differently than mice or foxes or elephants, but nobody would argue that they're not mammals. No. Bats are just a weird type of mammal that evolved wings and developed the ability to fly. Birds are just a weird group of dinosaurs that did the same thing. Birds are dinosaurs. How awesome is that? Book number four, Death by Black Hole, Another Cosmic Quandaries by Neil deGrasse Tyson. A quandary is a difficult situational problem. A dilemma. Neil deGrasse Tyson is one of my favorite people on earth, and he's one of today's best popularizers of science. He also was one of those people who were responsible for making Pluto a dwarf planet instead of a planet. He has a fantastic sense of humor, and he explains the most complicated stuff in astrophysics in the most simple and understandable way. So if you want to learn what would happen to you if you fell in a black hole, spoiler alert, nothing good, then definitely check out this book. And get excited about science and the world around us. If humans one day become extinct from a catastrophic collision, there would be no greater tragedy in the history of life in the universe. Not because we lack the brain power to protect ourselves, but because we lack the foresight. The dominant species that replaces us in post-apocalyptic Earth just might wonder as they gaze upon our mounted skeletons in their natural history museums. Why large-headed Homo sapiens fared no better than the proverbially pea-brained dinosaurs? Neil deGrasse Tyson also has a podcast, Star Talk, and you should definitely consider checking it out. So much fun! Book number 5, A History of the World in 100 Objects by Neil MacGregor. In the middle of 2020, I felt kinda trapped in my home. I wanted adventures. And by adventures, I mean walking freely outside and visiting museums or something. And this book, A History of the World in 100 Objects, helped me immensely to feel much better, because it was about objects from the British Museum. I felt like I had a personalized guided tour of that museum. You learn about people, customs, and countries from all over the world, from a few objects like a helmet or a piece of pottery. I found learning about lost civilizations especially fascinating, because objects were all was left from them. The book is written by now an ex-director of the British Museum, and is based on a podcast, A History of the World in 100 Objects. 17th century Europe was still largely illiterate. Even in the cities, no more than a third of people could read. So prints with images and just a few keywords were the most effective means of mass communication. Even today, we all know a well-crafted cartoon can be lethal in public debate. Nonfiction books are a wonderful choice for English learners because they help you boost your passive vocabulary on a variety of topics, discover new fantastic things about the world, and just have fun. Let me know in the comments down below, what is your favorite nonfiction book, in English or your native tongue? Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video and consider subscribing for more awesome language content.